What's up, everyone? We're back with another tutorial in Cubase. Today I'm going to explain the difference between track instruments and rack instruments. It's a somewhat confusing thing because they both basically do the same thing, but I'll tell you the differences, and then at the end I'll give you my opinion as to which one is better, asking you to keep in mind that opinions are like assholes. Everybody has one, and they all stink. But it is the internet, so people want you to have an opinion, and that's what I'm going to do. I'll tell you which one I favor. So let's begin with the rack instrument, why don't we? Here at our VST rack, we can choose an instrument, and I'll just use Haleon Sonic SE. It loads up just fine, and then it asks you, do you want to create a MIDI track assigned to plugin Haleon Sonic SE? And you do. So let me just give you a spoiler alert. I prefer track instruments to rack instruments because this is what we have going on here. This track right here is your instrument control. This track right here is your output for audio. So that's what you see here on your mixer. This is your audio output of the Haleon Sonic instance. And then this MIDI track is where you record data. So there's three tracks for one track, basically. So it's confusing as all get out. So I prefer the instrument tracks, but let's just dive into this rack instrument and see how it works. When you fire up Haleon Sonic SE, it's got that first contact preset. And let's take a look at these. So the rack instruments, I think they were designed so that you could do multi-timbral stuff. So I could add an acoustic piano here. Let's just go acoustic grand piano. So that's on channel 2. Now, if I add another MIDI track, we'll call it piano, to channel 2, and it automatically defaults to channel 2. You can see right there. I have acoustic grand piano, and here on channel 1 I'll have first contact. Now if I want multi-timbrality, where both of them are playing every time I hit the keyboard, all I really have to do is switch this acoustic piano 2 right here to channel 1. And then when I'm on the channel 1, you see I get multi-timbral responses. So this setup, this rack instrument setup, is good if you want to have 16 instruments. As you can see, we have 16 slots in the program rack for one instance of Haleon Sonic SE. But the reason why I feel track instruments are better is because computers have become so good that there's not too much overhead for firing up a different instance of each one and doing it that way. Because if we wanted to be able to independently control the volumes of these, we'd have to go into our mixer and assign an output here. So this could be out 2, this could be out 3, and we'll switch this back to channel 2. And then we'd have to come over here and activate our outputs, out 2, out 3. And once that's done, we come to our mixer, and out 2 is first contact, and out 3 would be our grand piano. So we do have the control, but it's just kind of clunky, if you ask me. So we go to first contact. Wait, here's first contact. As you can see, the volume here. And then we switch to the piano, and you'll be able to see the volume here. Piano. Wait, where is it? There. So, that's sort of how the rack instruments are designed to work, but it's kind of clunky, and I personally think that it's a bit of a pain in the ass to work with, especially when we're doing something like automation. So I have this output, this first contact. Now let's say I want to record automation. If I did it here, it wouldn't record the automation. The automation needs to be recorded here on the rack. And as you can see, it goes up here where the instrument is. So we play, I'll just record something. So that was recorded. Now, if I want to find my automation, I say, show me all automation. It doesn't show me nothing because it's the MIDI track. So to find automation, I have to come here where the automation was enabled, but I can't do show automation. I have to know which parameters I automated and then take a look at them. And then you can find the, you could draw in automation, but that's kind of a pain in the ass if you ask me. That's why I use track instruments. So let's just clear all this up and jump into track instruments and how I use them. So we'll just remove this stuff. Yes. We'll add an instrument track and we'll add Haleon Sonic SE. Add track. Now this functions basically the same way, but the only thing is that the volume slider here is an actual volume slider. So this right here is an instrument track, but you can control the volume, you can add audio inserts, and the only thing that you have to be wary of is that if you're trying to do multi-timbrality, which you can do with an instrument track, everything will be routed to this one volume unless you activate extra outputs. But like I said earlier, I think that computers have gotten to the point where if we wanted 10 instances of Haleon and 10 different instruments, instead of getting in here to the instrument rack and having 10 different things in the rack, you know, this Glockenspiel and then this vibraphone and this tubular bells. So instead of putting them all in the rack, I would just put them all in a different instrument track because that makes more sense to me. So this would be first contact. And then this could be, we'll call this Haleon Sonic. Add track, we'll call this Glockenspiel. Glock. And we will make this. And then each one is its own track with its own volume slider. So first contact. And we could pan. So it's a lot more flexibility when you're using instrument tracks, and you can just do one per track. And when I have huge templates set up, I've set up a preset. So here you can disable tracks. So if you had hundreds and hundreds of tracks, you can just right click and disable it, and then it'll unload. And I've actually assigned that to key command D. So as you can see, that goes away. But if I want to bring it back, I just hit D. So you can save overhead that way and just load up instrument tracks, as many as your heart desires. And then just get rid of this thing and do all of your control from the edit screen here. So your tone color. Use all those with your quick controls or whatever. So if we want to automate this, the automation is right here on the track. And now we'll have it read the automation. And you can see that all those fader moves I made are happening. And if I want to show all used automation, it'll actually give it to me right in this track. That's why instrument tracks are superior in my opinion. So this has been a quick explanation of the difference between rack instruments and track instruments. I hope that you got something out of it, and I'll be doing these Cubase videos every Monday, so if you have an idea for something for me to do, be sure to leave it in the comments. Thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great day. Bye.